Good day. I'm here to do a bit of a rundown on the new gas-gases that have hit the market this year. As you might be aware, GasGas went out of business a couple of years ago, and there was talk of KTM buying them out, and then the GasGas workers were burning effigies of KTM in the street because they didn't want that to happen. So then they were bought out by a company called Toro, who make electric bikes predominantly. And Toro have basically gone, hit the gases with a clean sheet of paper, redesigned them from the ground up, and this is the result. We've got two models here. This is the standard EC, and this is the GP model. The GP model is a little bit like what you'd see from KTM as a six-day special, or Beta as the racing edition, or Sherco do their factory edition as well. So they've all got a blinged up version and a standard version. The GasGas have probably gone a little bit further than most with the bling and the factory version, but we'll go over that. So just a bit of a run over the bike itself. A frame, it looks similar to an Austrian frame actually, but clearly it's made in Spain. The motor is quite different. It's not a 100% replacement from the old GasGas motor. You can still see the starter motor sits on the outside here on the angle like the older ones. The barrel is different, the power ports, the pipe, a lot of the important bits have been changed. It's really the bottom end and the gearbox and stuff that's still similar to the old motor. The elephant in the room, of course, is the suspension on these things. They've got a KYB fork and shock in them. The KYB is a triple S, or the AER, the new version of that. They're pretty much universally regarded as being the best fork on the market, and they are amazing. I've ridden the gases, and the suspension really is just absolute standout. I'll go into that a bit more later. We've got Nissan brakes. That's the same brakes that you find on Hondas and Yamahas and most of the Japanese bikes. So they really are about as good as it gets. I personally have always preferred the Nissans over the Europeans that you'll find on, the brakes that you'll find on the European bikes. It's just a bit of a feel thing. The Nissans have got a bit more of a progressive feel, whereas the Brembos and that have a bit more of a bitey feel. It just depends what you like, but I really like the Nissans. Up back, we've got a shock here from KYB as well. Linkage suspension, important note there. The suspension and the way the bikes actually ride, it's exceptional. It's about as good as you'll ever get out of a factory bike, I reckon. The suspension is very plush. I've ridden both of these, the EC300 and the GP300, and they're very plush on the small stuff, but when you hit something hard, they really do firm up. And so it's plush, but you've got the confidence to hit something as hard as you want, because you know if you make a mistake or if you hit something really hard, it's not going to spit you off. So they really are a confidence inspiring machine to ride. Compared to some of the other bikes around, it's a big bike. They're pretty tall and they're pretty wide between your knees, so they're suited to a larger rider. The GasGas also produce a lowering kit for them, because one of the reasons why they're so tall is they just have so much suspension travel. They sit quite high and they've got quite a lot of ground clearance. So there's a lowering kit that takes about an inch out of the front and the back. And if I personally was riding one of these, I would probably put the lowering kit in it just because in the hard enduro, which I pretty much ride a hard enduro these days only, it's really handy to have a lower seat height. I learned that from riding a Beta cross trainer for a little while ago. So the extra suspension that you get from the extra height is great when you're going fast, but when you're in the slow stuff, lower seat height is really handy. These bikes are like indestructible at speed. They really are. You can go as fast as you want and smash into anything you want. They'd be a really good desert racing bike and that sort of thing. The motor itself, everyone that rides a GasGas, I find, has a different impression of the motor. I actually rode it and said it's a bit soft off the bottom and it comes on really hard up top. Other people ride them and say they're really talky, but they're flat up top. So I think what that shows is that they're very sensitive to the power valve adjustments. You can actually turn this from a very smooth, linear, talky machine into a very aggressive machine. A little bit like the Beta in that sense, because they've both got that really good range of adjustment in the power valve, just from the screw, without actually having to go and change springs and stuff like you have to with the orange and the white bikes. So there's your suspension motor. The pipe on this thing, it's all done by FMF, so similar to what some of the other European manufacturers have done. They've gone and just engaged the best manufacturers of the particular components they can. And when you think about it, this bike has got Japanese forks, brakes, ignition. So there's a lot of Japanese in this thing, so they really are quite a nice mix of sort of Japanese precision and European flair, and it's sort of, when you ride it, you get that impression straight away that the suspension and everything, it just works so well. And the frame's really good. It's got very nice characteristics, and you can ride it fast or slow, and it's just super confidence inspiring. So lovely bikes to ride. So I'll get into now a little bit of the difference between the standard EC model and the GP model. So the GP model obviously is the blinged up version. So we'll start from the front, work our way back. On the very front here, there is a floating disc on the GP. Obviously give you a bit better brake feel. There's an axle puller on the side here. Pretty much all of the trick bikes tend to have the axle pullers on them. Different graphics. They've got the fork protectors. They've got stickers on them and the shroud. You've got the X-Trig triple clamps here, which are a really trick looking bit of kit actually. They and the expansion chamber for the GP is actually different to the standard. The barrel and the head are all different as well. The muffler actually has a slightly different diameter in it, so it's quite a lot of difference in it's not just bling on these things, it's actually also quite a lot of difference in the mechanicals. There's not a recluse clutch in there, it's just a recluse clutch cover because it's stronger. The staunchions on the fork, and this is probably my favourite bit of the whole thing, the staunchions on the KYBs are DLC coated, so that's a diamond-like coating on them, which is about, you know, one of the hardest substances known to man. Also, the internals, the internal damper rod and everything is DLC coated, so that is just about an A-spec fork that you'd find, you know, like a really high-end motocrosser running. It's about as good as you can possibly get, so that is a beautiful bit of suspension there. I think the shock is pretty much the same. They have a different sprocket on the back of the GP, and obviously different sticker kits for the whole GP as well. Riding the two of them, riding the standard EC as opposed to the GP is just a more potent machine. It's as soon as you start to roll the throttle on, it just cracks. And whether you're really, as soon as you get a little way off the very bottom and you start to even get a whiff of the mid-range, it just hauls ass. And so it'd probably be a more difficult bike to ride in hard enduro than a standard one. But if you were going racing at the Victorian Off-Road Championship sort of stuff, or typical off-road racing or desert racing or anything like that, this thing just hauls, probably pulls harder than any 300 I've ever ridden, I reckon. It's like the old days of the KTMs when they first made 300s and they were, you know, just large capacity 250s before they started dowing them down. So really, really potent machine to ride. Awesome though, like if you can just smash into bumps on these things, and if you're coming out of a corner, third or fourth gear corner, where you're carrying a fair bit of speed and there's a whole lot of really square edge choppy stuff, you can just relax. You just relax and just roll the throttle on, it just eats it up and takes you through it. So a lot of other bikes, you tense up and sort of ride through the real rough stuff. So very confidence inspiring, and they don't wear you out because the suspension is just so good. What else have we got? Have a look on the other side here. That's about it for the differences between the GP. It's got a different seat. It's got a bit of a gripper on the seat here. Heads and everything the same. Oh, the GP's got black spokes where the EC has got silver spokes. They're both XL rims on both models, so more Japanese bits on there. So you can see that between when GasGas has done the GP model, they've really taken a pretty holistic approach at it. They've put different suspension, different motor, bling. They've really gone a little bit further than the average manufacturer does. And they've also actually made a bike which is quite different to ride. It really is substantially more aggressive to ride. So if you go riding on your two banger and you want to keep up with your mates on their 450s on the faster stuff, this thing will kill a 450 up until about 80 k's an hour and run with them no problem up until about 120. And whereas, you know, that's on the open sort of terrains, whereas the standard model, like any 300, is not quite going to be as fast on the open terrain as a 450. So I think that's about it. I think I've hit the major points there. But all in all, pretty impressive bit of gear, especially for their first time out. I mean, often when you get manufacturers release a bike for the first time, it's got lots of little quirks and stuff. I know a few people have been riding these bikes for a while now and have reasonably big hours on them, and there's no dramas with them. They seem to be pretty bulletproof and they just work. So